Tony Metro, G1NBC TV, This Day with candidate Gary Brown, here live at the Russell Bazaar. Gary, how's everything going?
Oh, it's going great, Tony, and I really do appreciate and thank you for having me here today.
Tell me a little bit more about what's going on. Let everybody know at home what's going on with Gary Brown.
Well, as most people in the city of Detroit know, I spent 26 years in the Detroit Police Department, and now I'm closing the door on that part of my life, and I'm trying to open up a new door, and I'm running hard to earn a position as a city council person in the city of Detroit.
Now, I read on your website that you're a U.S. veteran and you spent time in the United States Marine. Can you tell us, our viewers, a little bit more about that?
Sure. I spent about 2 years in the Marine Corps. It was at a time in my life when I really needed to grow up. And so I really went into the Marine Corps so that it would help me pay for college when I got out. And I joined and really got a good sense of what leadership was all about in the Marine Corps. I was fortunate enough to be promoted 4 times within a 2-year period based on the leadership skills that I had learned in the Marine Corps. And I think it's going to bode me well on Detroit City Council.
Why are you running and what is your goals, Gary?
That's a good question. I'm running for Detroit City Council because I think that I have a skill set that is tailor-made for the job based on my work history. But more importantly, I'm running because I love this city. I truly love this city. And I think that Detroit, there's an opportunity here for Detroit to move forward, go in a new direction. And I think that I'm just the person to be able to lead it in that direction.
Now, Gary, I noticed you have some experiences of doing business and everything, Gary and Associates. Can you elaborate a little bit more about your business experiences and budgets that you dealt with in your past?
Sure, I can, Tony. I did start a company, Brown and Associates, that's basically a consultant firm, and it's doing quite well. But prior to joining the Marine Corps, I worked at a chain supermarket in Detroit called Farmer Jack's. I started as a bagger. I worked my way up within a 5-year period of time to become the assistant manager. And I'm very proud to say that store, with only 3 parts of management, was able to have a gross revenues of about $10 million a year. So I learned quite a bit about budgets. I learned quite a bit about how to manage people with my Farmer Jack experience.
Well, how do you expect to achieve your goals once you accomplish the city council situation in the city of Detroit?
Well, those goals, it's this simple, Tony. On the city council, there are two basic functions that the city council is responsible for. As you know, we have a strong mayor form of government, the executive branch, and the city council is really a legislative branch. And the two main functions on city council are to pass the mayor's budget, as well as make sure the money's being spent as it was intended to. The second function has to do with creating policy. And in my career with the Detroit Police Department, I was able to write policy. I've also taught policy formation at the university level, at the University of Detroit. And so those two things, being able to bring my experience from the business world with regards to budgets and bring my experience with regard to writing policy and teaching policy to the city council makes me an excellent candidate for that position.
26 years in the police department, United States Marine. Let's talk about leadership. What is the view of your definition of leadership that you can bring to the Detroit City Council?
Well, you know, in Detroit, it's too bad that we're at a period in our history where we have to start out talking about integrity, character, and honesty. Certainly, I think I have the leadership skills necessary to bring to that job, but it's really the character, honesty, that Detroit is lacking, and as a leader, I'm going to bring that to the table at City Council.
Well, it looks like it really needs that right about now, because there's a lot of things changing, a lot of things going on with the school systems and everything, and you can see yourself in a fit to be able to make that change, just like the President Barack Obama. I noticed you had a couple of pictures on your website with him, and so you can do some changes in a positive way for the city of Detroit, because it's a great city. Is that correct?
And that's my objective. That's my goal, to be able to make my community a little bit better than I found it. Again, I think I have the skill sets, the leadership leadership ability, the other skills that are necessary in order to help move the city forward. And certainly our city council right now is lacking leadership, and I think I bring that to the table.
Now, how, you said 26 years the police department. How does your law enforcement background will help tie all this in so we can get Detroit back on the right track?
Yeah, that's a good question. While I was on the police department, I was the commander of four different precincts within the community. And so I have a good sense from being a commander in a neighborhood precinct of what the community concerns are. And as the commander, I was responsible for taking care of the complaints of citizens within their community. And so what else are you asking a city council person to do other than solve citizens' complaints? But more importantly, I've also been a block club captain, and I'm currently serve on the role of my neighborhood association board of directors, and I'm in charge of the committee that's responsible for vacant houses in our neighborhood. And so I'm acutely aware of how the neighborhood has to come together and cut the grass at these vacant buildings because the city doesn't have the money to do it. We board up the houses because we know the city doesn't have the money to do it. And so nobody's coming into Detroit, Barack Obama or anybody, to save ourselves. And if Detroit is to turn around, it's going to have to be done block by block, neighborhood association by neighborhood association. And we got to stop waiting for people to come in and save us. And that's where I think the leadership comes in. And also the experience of being a block club captain, of being a neighborhood association board member. I also sit on the board of directors of the Mariners Inn, which is a homeless shelter for drug dependent men. And in that capacity, I'm able to affect lives. And I think that if you can save one man, you've saved a family.
So basically, you're just rolling up your sleeves to do everything. How does your family feel about what you're doing, and how does their role in a positive manner of them helping and supporting you on this situation of running for city council? I know it's a heavy load, but somebody's got to do it, and you look like the man to be able to complete the job.
Thank you. My family is working extremely hard to support me, to work on this campaign. My kids, my wife, they all have a role in the campaign with regards to helping me get elected, and they're extremely supportive, and they're working just as hard as I am to make this happen.
So there's a lot of sacrifice there and everything, and I can understand that, Gary. Well, Gary, is there anything else you'd like to tell everybody out there on G1NBC.com? Let them know about your website and different things they can get in contact with you with?
Yes, I want to thank you for having me, and certainly we do have a website. The name of it is www.electgarybrown.com, and we urge anyone that wants to get involved with our campaign, no matter how small or how large, to contact us on the website and to volunteer to give us a hand, because we want to turn this city around, and I think we can do it if we elect Gary Brown and move the city in a new direction. Thank you.
Well, Gary, thank you for coming out. I really do appreciate it. It's Tony Metro, G1NBC TV, This Day Coast to Coast. Thank you for tuning in.
My name is Gary Brown, and I'm running for Detroit City Council. I want to thank all the Detroiters that voted for me in the primary, and ask even more Detroiters to vote for me in the general election. This election is really about leadership, and I think that I have the leadership that it takes to move this city forward. If you expect the city's crime problem to be reduced, I'm the person for that job. If you expect DPS, Detroit Public School System, to educate our kids, I can help do that. If you expect a city council person to get the budget under control, Gary Brown can do that. I can only do it with your help, your support. If you're willing to help, then please contact my website at www.electgarybrown.com. We all know that Detroit has been a great city in the past, and it's going to be even a better city in the future. But only if you get involved and get out and vote and make a difference. So again, I urge you on November 3rd to please get out. And remember, Gary Brown has the leadership skills that Detroit needs to help move it forward. And please vote on November 3rd. Thank you very much.